before, but did you ever think, you know, it would come to this?
No, I mean, this is never in the back of the mind, front of the mind, wherever. Just talking with Molly, I don't know that I've had a more frustrating stretch that I can even remember. You know, I completely understand where they're coming from, and I understand that they got to make a change, and I got things that I need to work on. It's a whole lot easier to work on those in AAA than it is here when you're trying to, you know, win games and get big league hitters out.
What do you feel like you really need to kind of work on? Is it much like the command?
I mean, a little bit of everything. I think, you know, I had a good talk with Falvey and Levine just about, you know, getting a plan together about, you know, whether it's attacking the zone, whatever it is. But I think, you know, there's room for improvement when you have, you know, six starts where you're scuffling like this. So, yeah, I think I'll go back and look at a lot of it and try to improve in each area, really. You can't pick one area that causes you to throw, you know, poorly for six starts. So I'm getting ahead of guys, you know, attacking guys with two strikes, using all my pitches in the zone as well.
What's your level of frustration as the game goes on? I mean, you know all this going into it, but this has been happening. How are you feeling between innings?
I mean, in game, it's you know, not as frustrating as it is, you know, after the game when you look back and you go watch the video and you see, you know, certain pitches here and there where you just should have executed better. But yeah, I mean, it's always frustrating when you're giving up runs. You know, my goal out there is to go put up a zero every inning and give the offense a chance to win a game. And you know, unfortunately, I haven't done that.
How do you prepare yourself for, you know, meeting a manager for, you know, new GM,
you try to keep it out of the back of your mind and you try to not think about it, but you got to understand that you have to perform and you have to throw better. And you have to compete out there. It's something that it sucks every time. You know, I don't even remember how many times I've been sent down, but, you know, it's not fun. Whether you're a non-roster invite and you get sent out of spring training or you're, you know, middle of the season getting optioned down. You know, everybody wants to be here. Everybody wants to be winning big league games, and it stinks every time.
Is there any confidence that has to be regained or anything like that? How do you feel mentally with where
things are? I mean, it's been up and down. I mean, I'd be lying to you if I sat here and said I'm, you know, at the same confidence as I had in, you know, 2015, obviously. It tends to wear on you a little bit. You know, you go out there and you feel like you execute pitches, and, you know, I can think of a few at-bats today where I execute a good pitch and the guy hits a base hit. You know, it's frustrating and it wears on you a little bit. But it's not like I'm going to be going down there and facing, you know, a bunch of guys who don't know how to play the game either. I'm not just going down there for a confidence boost. That's not it. I got things to work on, and I'm going to get to work.
Does it make it more frustrating that you've made changes in the offseason, you know, after last year, in terms of some of the stuff you did that it hasn't really carried over yet in the regular season?
I mean, the changes I made in the offseason weren't necessarily just trying to, you know, make my stuff better. The changes were just trying to stay healthy and keep my arm feeling good. My arm feels great. I don't know that I felt, you know, as frustrating as I've been with the results. I don't know that I've had in the last 2 years a stretch of six starts where I felt this good consistently, whether it's in the bullpen, pregame, during the game. I feel like my fastball has, you know, as much life on it that's been in the last couple of years, and I have a lot of confidence in it. So, you know, the off-season stuff was more, hey, let's get into spring training feeling strong and feeling good and try to avoid the shoulder and back issues, and for the most part, I've done that. So this is more just executing. Maybe it's sequencing. I mean, there's a lot of things that kind of go into, you know, whether you're struggling or having success. So it's just, you know, take a step back, you know, get back to the basics and get back to the ball how I want to.
You mentioned sequencing, Kyle. They've been talking to you kind of from the get-go here about things to work on. Is there something specific you said to you to work on?
No, we haven't really gone over the plan yet. But, I mean, I know for me, one thing I want to do is just get ahead of more guys. I mean, even as bad as I've been, or as bad as the numbers have been, you know, I just looked at it. Guys are only hitting 250 when I'm ahead in the count. You know, to me, that just says I got to be ahead more. You know, for me, it's getting strike one, getting strike two as soon as possible, and you know, putting guys away and not letting them work six, seven pitch at bats and find a way on base.
For sure.